In the spring of 2008, the winner of the Winvex Award was announced, the Smart Textiles Initiative. Winning the award secured textile research worth 7 million Swedish crowns per year over the coming 8 years. This is an important achievement for the Swedish textile industry. Since then, the Smart Textiles Initiative has received a lot of attention, not only from regional businesses and organizations, but also in local and national media.
We have had 3 years to build up new research in different areas, and hopefully we can continue to cooperate, and there will be a lot of new interesting product, textile products on the market in just a few months, in a year, and I'm hopeful for the future.
There is more to smart textiles than textiles with smart applications. Both functional and technical materials are important parts of the field. Company-driven projects that forms the link between research and business today comprise over 50 projects.
The aim with company-driven project is to stimulate and initiate company projects together with different companies in order to generate growth, both turnover and also personnel growth. The idea is also to connect different competences in order to start development projects and research projects.
In the fall of 2010, one company-driven project in particular attracted broad attention, the knitted blood vessel.
What I have in my hand is a prototype, a little bit early prototype of the Y-graft, which is kind of representing what the nature does itself in natural vascular architecture. And this has been developed here in Borås at Smart Textiles, together with these very skillful technicians you have in the knitting lab. Well, if everything turns out fine, then maybe in 2 years' time it will be a test on someone's leg.
The knitted blood vessel is one example of a long-term company-driven project. There are also shorter projects within the second part of business innovation, the prototype factory. Here, most companies and innovators turn to gain access to the advanced and unique machinery at the Swedish School of Textiles.
It's time now for the business innovation side to grow, to continue to have more focus on companies, more applications, and also attract other companies to be connected to smart textiles.
Within company-driven projects, we are also working with the personal protective equipment, and I'm actually standing next to one dress that we have developed together with the company TST Sweden. It's a dress for ultra-high water pressure, where you are cleaning oil rigs. And all these stripy parts of this dress contains this special material that was developed within the project. This dress is one of the products that we have in the textile material library, which is actually a market window for all people interested in the future of textiles, where we have gathered both prototypes and also products developed within the initiative.
In addition to business innovation, Smart Textiles also has a section with two labs for experimental research, Design Lab and Technology Lab. The main focus of the Smart Textiles Design Lab is to explore and develop new expressions, new materials and constructions in textile design. A number of doctoral students and researchers at the Swedish School of Textiles, Chalmers University of Technology, and the University of Gothenburg are connected to Design Lab and continually experiment with and develop tomorrow's textiles.
Here at the Smart Textile Design Lab, we have several ongoing projects, such as light in textiles, craft, acoustics, and dynamic patterns in textiles. One of the projects is textile resistance. This is a project by Linda Warbin, Barbara Schultz, and Mika Satomi in collaboration with Cynthia Tan. The project explores design possibilities of raw textile materials that can be used as textile musical instruments. Garments and fabric samples were knit with conductive yarn, using techniques such as crochet, hand knitting, and machine knitting to get different kinds of constructions that would allow for resistance change in the circuit. When the knit pieces are stretched or tickled, it changes the resistance of the current, and in this case, it has been used as an interface for a synthesizer.
The technical part of the experimental research section is found in the Smart Textiles Technology Lab. Together with the School of Engineering at University of Borås, Chalmers University of Technology, Sveria IVF, and the SP Technical Research Institute of Sweden. Research is conducted in various fields, such as technical and medical textiles, acoustics and conductive fibers.
We are covering the whole range, going from fibers to fabrics. And one of the materials that has been developed is the phase-changing fiber. And here is a fabric made of this fiber. And having this in your T-shirt, for example, you could keep your temperature constant when you're hot. The hot goes inside the material and is stored there. And then when you stop exercising, the heat will go to your body by this keeping you constant.
Borås University should be the natural player for the textile industry. And that is, of course, the main goal for the years after 2016, where we would like to see this region as a natural part of the global industry for textile.